very much today. Jesus began his ministry, there was this moment of the first miracle we're talking about today, this wedding at Cana and the turning water into wine. There are moments in our own lives when we are waiting for a miracle, we're waiting for you to intervene. And whether it's through the waters of baptism that remind us of our forgiveness, or the bread and wine of communion that once again give us this forgiveness of sins, or whether it's through the Word as we read and study and think and ponder and meditate on what you say, and are inspired to a deeper faith, a deeper trust in what you say and who you are. You're here again this morning. And we're asking you, Father in heaven, that you would not only fill this place, but pour out your Holy Spirit upon each one of us. So we would set aside the thoughts and worries of the week and of the day. And let this be an opportunity for us to gather with fellow believers to stand in your presence, as if we're standing in the presence of heaven. To acknowledge that you are our God and we are your people. We come to give you thanks and praise, to sing your praise, to listen to your word. And we come in Jesus' name. Amen. Psalm 36. Let him lead me to the banquet hall. Your love, O Lord, reaches to the heavens. Your righteousness is like the highest mountains.
Your justice like the great deep. You, Lord, preserve both people and animals.
How precious is your unfailing love, O God.
People take refuge in the shadow of your wings.
They feast on the abundance of your house.
You give them drink from your river of delights.
For with you is the fountain of life.
In your life we see life.
Glory be to the Father and to the Son.
And to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning,
it is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Let them lead me to the banquet hall.
And let us there lead me up.
I cry to you for help, O Lord.
In the morning my prayer comes before you.
Out of the depths I cry to you, O Lord. O Lord, hear my voice.
Let your ears be attentive to my cry for mercy.
I cry to you, O Lord.
According to the Gospel of John, Jesus' first miraculous sign in his ministry took place in Cana of Galilee. Jesus was there, probably with his family. His mother, Mary, was certainly there, for it was she who prompted the miracle to take place. At the festivities, they had unfortunately run out of wine. Mary approached Jesus about this, but he told her the time wasn't right. She, in turn, instructed the servants to do whatever he told them to do. Jesus instructed them to fill 6 large jars with water. The water was turned into wine. 120 to 180 gallons of wine, to be precise. The memorial to this miracle is preserved at the wedding church of Cana. Many renew their vows of marriage at this spot. One can wander the small courtyards to contemplate the beginning of Jesus' miraculous ministry and the way his mother played a role in revealing him. The beautiful interior of the chapel points toward the miraculous activity that happened there 2 millennia ago. And one can descend below the church to view the remains of earlier chapels and on down to the first century remains of Cana of Galilee. Jesus was in Cana another time when a royal official from Capernaum begged Jesus for healing for his son. Jesus pronounced him healed from Cana, and when the man took him at his word and departed, the boy was healed. The scriptures also tell us that the disciple Nathanael was from Cana. Today, Cana is a Palestinian village just miles from Nazareth, in the heart of the Galilee, where Jesus lived, ministered, and changed the course of history.
Thank you. various other ways you can be a part of it. Specifically for this crowd right here, in 2017, we're hoping to bring something called the Offspring Festival to Indianapolis. So what that is a 2,000-hour community service event done by our youth, and also a music festival. This year in Crown Point, where I come from, is Building 429. It's going to be the top band that's going to be playing out there, plus six other bands. We're hoping to bring the same kind of thing here in 2017. There's an interest form and also some information out there about that, as well as some other stuff. For you Green Bay Packer fans, there's comfort food out there. Information on it that we'd love to give you guys as well. I'm supposed to say something else.